同学们好，今天我们来学习第35课 Lesson 35 Our Village。 在这篇课文当中，我们通过三幅照片来了解一个村庄 A Village。 好，下面我们就一起来看课文，请回答这样一个问题。 Are the children coming out of the park or going into it? 孩子们是正从公园里走出来还是正往里走？
This is a photograph of our village. Our village is in a valley. It is between two hills. The village is on a river. Here is another photograph of the village. My wife and I are walking.Along the banks of the river. We are on the left. There is a boy in the water. He is swimming across the river. Here is another photograph. This is the school building. It is beside a park.The park is on the right. Some children are coming out of the building. Some of them are going into the park.
好，现在请大家回答我的问题。Are the children coming out of the park or going into it? They are going into it. 孩子们现在正往公园里面走去。你答对了吗？好，我们一起来看本课当中的关键词和词组，请跟我读。Keywords and expressions: photograph, village, valley, hill, another, bank, swim, building, park。好，我们一起来看本课当中的主要语言点。This is a photograph of our village. 在每一段的开头呢，都有这样的一句话来说明这是我们村庄的一张照片。A photograph of our village. Photograph 在口语当中还可以简略地说成 photo. Our village is in a valley. 我们的村庄在山谷里。It is between two hills.它在两座小山之间。The village is on the river. 村庄呢，靠近一条小河。这三句话讲的是我们的村庄的具体位置，用了三个介词短语。第一个是 in a valley， 在山谷中。其中 in 和 a 连读成为 inner。第二个介词短语是 between two hills。在两座小山之间 ，between and， 在什么和什么之间 ，between a hill and a river， 在一座小山和一条小河之间。第三个介词短语是 on the river， 这个 on 并不是在河上的意思，而是靠近、临近的意思。再看一个例子 ，a house on the road， 在公路旁边的房子。Here is another photograph of the village. 这是我们村庄的另外一张照片。Another 指的是三者或者三者以上的其中之一。My wife and I are walking along the banks of the river. 我和我的妻子正沿着河岸走着。Along 沿着 ，walk along 沿着什么在走 ？The banks of the river 河岸。Bank 这个词还有一个意思就是银行。那么在英文当中，如果表达我和什么人，我 I 一般要放在最后。比如说，我和我的父母亲 ，My father, mother, and I。那么这幅图当中呢，还有一个小男孩，他在哪呢 ？There is a boy in the water. In the water 在这儿， 指的是在河里，也就是 in the river。 那么他正在做什么呢？ He is swimming across the river。 他正横渡小河。请注意 swim 这个词，它变成现在分词的时候双写了最后一个字母，然后才加上 ing。 Across 穿过横过，它可以看作是 along 的反义词。下面一张图片， This is the school building。 那么在这张图片当中呢，有一座教学楼， school building。 如果是办公楼，我们可以说 office building。 It is beside a park。 它在公园旁边。 Beside 在什么什么的旁边，我们还可以说 next to。 It is next to a park。Some children are coming out of the building. 一些孩子们正从大楼里出来。Some of them are going into the park. 他们中的一些人呢，正在向公园里走去。Some of them are going into the park. 他们中的一些正在向公园里走去。Some of them, 他们中的一些人。好，看过课文的语言点之后呢，我们来总结一下今天学的基本句型是什么。在这课当中，我们学习的仍然是现在进行时，所不同的是和现在进行时连用的是一些介词短语，它们表示方向和位置。 Where is, where are? Where is he going? 他正向哪儿走去？ He's going into a park. 他正走到公园里去。Where are you walking? 你们正在哪散步？ We are walking along the street. 我们正沿着街道散步。好，让我们再看一遍课文的内容，这次请大家跟读，并且注意和现在进行时连用的介词短语。
This is a photograph of our village. Our village is in a valley.It is between two hills. The village is on a river. Here is another photograph of the village. My wife and I are walking along the banks of the river. We are on the left. There is a boy in the water.He is swimming across the river. Here is another photograph. This is the school building. It is beside a park. The park is on the right. Some children are coming out of the building. Some of themare going into the park.
好，下面我们进入下一课的学习，来练习一下含有介词短语的现在进行时。 Lesson 36 Where Going into 在这个练习当中，我们还是每幅图来做两句话，第一句话中询问动作的位置或者方向，第二句话来回答。Where is the man going? He's going into the shop. Sitting beside. Where is he sitting? He's sitting beside his mother. Walking across. Where are they walking? They are walking across the street.Walking between. Where is the man walking? He's walking between two policemen. Sitting near. Where is the girl sitting? She's sitting near the tree. Flying under. Where is the airplane flying? It's flying under the bridge. Sitting on. Where are they sitting? They are sitting on the grass. Reading in. Where are they reading? They are reading in the living room. 在这个教学单元中，我们继续巩固了所学的现在进行时，并且加入了一些表示位置和方向的介词短语。请大家在课后多做练习，复述课文。你还可以向你的朋友、家人来讲述一张照片或者一幅图画。好了，今天的课就到这儿了。Thank you and goodbye.